A 750 kg hammer of a drop hammer pile driver falls from a height of 1.2 meters onto the top of a pile as shown in figure. The pile is driven 100 mm into the ground. Determine the average distance of the ground to penetration. Assume mass of pile as 2250 kg. First, let us write the given data. So mass of the hammer is given. So let us consider that one with suffix 1. So which is given as 750 kg. And mass of the pile is given as 2250 kg. And the distance dropped is given as 1.2 meter. So the hammer is dropped from a certain height of 1.2 meter onto the pile. So distance is given. So let us consider it as S, which is 1.2 meter. Here what we have to find is, so here the hammer is going to be dropped onto the pile. So then it is going to be penetrated into the ground. So like this, after penetration let it be like this. So it is driven up to a distance of 100 mm. So when it is penetrated, so in the opposite direction it will be having reaction. So this reaction we have to calculate. So it is nothing but a problem associated with the law of conservation of momentum and work energy theorem. So with the help of work energy theorem, first we will use law of conservation of momentum. With the help of law of conservation of momentum, first we will find with what velocity it is penetrated into the ground. For that, first we have to find with what velocity it has impact on the pile. So for that we will use law of conservation of momentum. So we states that initial momentum is equal to final momentum, m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 plus m2 into v. So here m1 is mass of the hammer, u1 is initial velocity of the hammer, m2 is mass of pile, u2 is initial velocity of pile. So this is initial before impact. So this is after impact. Let v be the velocity with which the pile is penetrated into the ground, right? So we don't know the initial velocity of hammer with which it strike the pile. So for calculating that, so we will use this relation, v square minus u square equal to 2as. From that, v is equal to square root of u square plus 2as. Initially the hammer is under the state of rest, so its initial velocity is 0. So a is nothing but acceleration due to gravity here, which is g, 9.81, and displacement. So it has a displacement of 1.2 meter given there. So mention 1.2 here. So if you calculate here, so you will get 4.852 meter per second. So this is nothing but the initial velocity of the hammer. So this is the initial velocity of hammer. And initially the pile is under the state of rest, so its initial velocity will be equal to 0. So it will be equal to 0. Substituting these values, 750 is the mass of hammer and initial velocity of hammer with which it strike the pile is nothing but 4.852 plus mass of pile is 2250 into 0 is equal to 750 plus 2250 into V. If you simplify, you will get the value of V is 1.213 meter per second. Right? So with this velocity, it has impact on the pile. So that means it is the initial velocity of the pile. and when it reaches this point, its final velocity is equal to zero. So we will use work energy principle here in order to find the resistance value. So according to work energy theorem, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Work done is nothing but product of force and displacement. Here, the force caused by these two is nothing but product of force and displacement. So here 750 plus 2250, these are masses. If we multiply with 9.81, it will become force. So this is the force in this direction. So in this direction the force is applied and it is moving in this direction, and resistance is in the opposite direction. So resistance is also a force you have to consider in the opposite direction. Into work done is nothing but product of force and displacement. Here the displacement is 100 mm, so nothing but 0.1 meter is equal to change in kinetic energy. You can write half mv square, which is nothing but half into mass is nothing but 750 plus 2250 into v square minus u square. You have to consider here, right? So this is change in kinetic energy, to v square minus u square. So here when this pile reaches this point, its final velocity is zero and it has been driven with a velocity of 1.213 meter per second. So if you simplify this one, you will get the value of R, so which is around 51482.3 newtons. So this is the penetration resistance to this is the value of resistance to the penetration of the ground. Thank you for watching. Hope you like this video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel and click on the bell symbol to get all the notifications.